In this video, I will show you an idea how to create a Pinterest-like layout using exclusively CSS. This layout will allow you to tag images and other elements of various sizes in a specified number of columns. This gives the users a fresh look compared to the standard bootstrap layout. There are a bunch of possibilities how to do that, but in this video, we will focus on the columns CSS property. Hello and welcome. Thank you for coming and joining me in this video. My name is Artur, and here at my channel, I'm challenging you with various web dev ideas. In this video, we will explore how to use the columns CSS property to build a Pinterest-like layout in which multiple images of different sizes are stacked one below another in multiple columns. We are going to jump right into the code. So let's start with creating an empty HTML. We will use emmet for that. So HTML 5, and now I press tab to fill all the blanks. So I'm good with the default viewport metadata. The title, I will set it to Pinterest like layout with CSS columns. And now let's create some images. We will start with a main element, and inside this main element, we will want an image SRC attribute. For now, let's leave it empty, and I will need, let's say, a few of those. So I'll copy and paste a few times. Okay, so where can we get the images from? I think let's go with Pixabay. I have it in here. That's pixabay.com. And we can search for anything that we like. So let's go, for example, with winter, because it's winter outside. And as you can see, there's plenty of images. And what is very interesting for us is the orientation option in here. I can choose either horizontal, so all the images in here would be horizontal, or also I can select vertical, and then I will have all of those in a vertical mode. Press anything in here, and then you can click free download and download. Of course, prove that you're not a robot, and then you can download. So I will do it with a few pictures, and I'll get back to code in a second. Right, so I have all the images downloaded in here. There's plenty of those. They are horizontal and also vertical. And somewhere here I had an image that is square. Here it is. Also, I've created here a license .txt file where I copied the license from Pixabay, so I remember where I got those images from. So let's jump back to the code and let's just enter the sources in here in the images. So let's go with img and here architecture, and so on. So I will fast forward right now so you don't get bored. Now let's preview what we have in here. So there's plenty of images right now, but they are all huge. So let's do some styling in here. I will be using a less file. I have an extension in here enabled, which is called EasyLess, which will create a CSS file for me every time that I save the less file. Let's start by setting some options on the container. So my main, I'm going to set it to have 80% of the width. So width 80%. Also, I would like some margin here. That would be 1m at the top and bottom and automatic on the left and right. Also, when in main, I would like the images for now to take 100% of the size. So inside main, I'm adding img, and here I'm going to set the width to 100%. Now what I need to do is just add this columns CSS file that got generated in here for me into my HTML. So link relation is stylesheet type text CSS, and the head would be columns CSS. And when I save, all the images are in here right now. They are all in a single column, and we want plenty of those columns actually. So this is what we will be doing right now. For columns, we will be using a feature of CSS that is called columns. So let's see that in MDN. So actually, the columns CSS is a shorthand property which sets the number of columns to use or the width of columns to use when we want the contents of an element to be rendered in a few columns. So for example, in this sandbox in here, we can set the number of columns to 2 or maybe three, or maybe even four, or just one. Or we could set the column to be 12m, or maybe 2m, or 3m, or 4m, or 5m. So that's the width of the columns, so we can manipulate either how many columns we want, 1, 2, or 3, or how wide we want these columns to be, 2, 3, 4. You can see it's getting wider and wider. So here are examples of syntax, but what we are most interested in right now is at the very bottom, what about the support? And as you can see, this feature is now supported in majority of the browsers, so we're good to go with columns. So let's jump back to the code and we will add this property to our main element. So I'm setting columns and I could, for example, set it to two columns and save. And you can see we have everything in two columns, but then when I make the screen wider, they just grow narrower. There are just very, very little. So that's not what we are interested in. So maybe instead, let's set it to a specified width. So let's make it, for example, 150 pixels and save. And you can see it's looking a bit better, but maybe let's make it slightly wider, 250, and refresh. So this is how it looks. It is too big right now for me. So I'm getting back to 200 maybe. Yes, that's exactly what I'm interested in. So now what we are left with is making those images a little bit rounded. So let's get back to IMG and I'm going to specify the border radius. Let's make it 10 pixels and it's looking better. So now what we are left with is the gap between the columns in here and the margins top bottom. So actually, for the left right, let's adjust it with column gap. I'll make it 10 pixels and margin bottom on the image, I'll set to 10 pixels as well. So that's how it's looking. Let's make it a little bit wider so we have three columns and so on. So now let's test it in some real browsers. So let's start with Edge and it's looking quite okay, actually. Let's go to Chrome and it is looking exactly the same, and Firefox is looking good as well. Actually, I think let's add some more images in here just to make sure. So back to columns HTML, I will just copy it and paste again and maybe again save. So we have the list very, very long. And now let's go to Edge again, refresh, and it's looking quite okay. When I open the DevTools, I can manipulate the width. So that's three columns, and here we have two columns, and here we have one column. So that's looking quite okay. What is important to notice though, when you're using columns, you no longer have the layout going left, right. It's going top, bottom until you end this column, and then you get back in here. So that's another column, top, bottom. So this is very visible in here, because I duplicated the lines three times. Actually, when I have three columns, I have all the images repeat top, bottom.
I really hope you enjoyed this video and that you will be able to use this idea in your own front-end projects. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to subscribe. I encourage you to share your comments and ideas in the discussions. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.